in our lives, we have limitations, right? We can't do everything we want, right? So I'm going to ask you, so you can tell me a little bit, what kind of limitations do you have? Well, does everybody know what limitations is? Does everybody understand the term? The limit, you can't do everything, right? So what kind of limitation would there be in your life? What do you have? How old you are. There are things you can't do. Your whole life is limited, so we have a limited lifespan, physical lifespan, right? But of course it goes on after that, right? God gives us that gift, that our life goes on. The soul is immortal, given that gift. But we only have a few years here, 70, 80, 90 years of life, right? What are the limitations?
Oh, we can't like fly like birds. We can't fly like a bird.
We can't fly like a bird. No, right? Right? We don't have the physical attributes. Our wings aren't big enough, and our bones are too heavy, right? So we can't get off the ground and learn how to fly. Right? What else?
Laws and rules.
Oh, laws and rules. Do we make those up? No. Where do we get some of these laws and rules? God made them, right? God made them. There's the laws of the universe. Are there laws that, the rules that we make up to limit ourselves? Like what? What's an example? Did we make that up or were we given that rule? We were given that rule, right? Not to murder, right? And that's somebody else's chance.
Are you drugs and alcohol?
Yeah, we shouldn't do those things, right? Because they affect our mind. So we make up these rules, right? How about when we're driving a car? Right? There's a rule. They posted on the side of the road, right? You can't go above 65 miles an hour. And we're supposed to obey that, right? Why is that? Why would they do something like that? To keep us safe, right? Or to preserve us so we can have those 60, 70, 80 years that we're going to be working on. So there are limitations in our lives. How about some very personal limitations? These are like broad scope things. You gave me limitations that God has created for us. We can't fly. He gave that gift to the birds and to the angels. Not to us, we're grounded, right? He said, don't kill one another. Instead of that, what are we supposed to do? To love. And that's limitless, right? So it has to be. Love has to be. It should be forever. What about some personal limitations? Has anybody ever experienced a personal limitation?
Try not to eat sweets.
Try not to eat sweets. Why? Because what would happen to you?
Unhealthy.
It's unhealthy to eat fat, basically. Right? I had some limitations when I was growing up. When I was about your age, I was terrified to speak to people. Put two, three people in front of me, I couldn't talk. It was a limitation. They stopped me from doing things. Do they still do public speaking in grade school? In middle school, you have to stand up and give a report the first time. You have to write the report for the teacher once you stand up and read it, right? Does everybody have to do that still?
No.
Anybody? No. Has anybody done it recently? Yeah. Your throat gets strong. Anybody get nervous? Your lip quivers, right? Right? And you're not even sure when you've done reading, you're not even sure whether you read what you wrote, you know, and they pop like, oh, now. Right? And the teacher says, well, that was pretty good. And you get a little confidence, right? Then the next time it's easy. It's easy. So there's a personal limitation. You thought you weren't good at speaking in public. And so you were nervous. You were afraid of what other people were going to think. And then after you have some confidence, the limitation starts to go away, right? What are the limitations? Oh, a sports limitation, right? You want to play baseball, and in your mind you're the pitcher, and then they try out. And what happens when you have tryouts? Everybody shows up, right? And the coach picks what for pitchers? How many on a baseball team?
A couple,
right? Two, three, four. The guys that can really throw well, and everybody else, first base, second base, outfield, right? limitations that God has created, right? In the natural universe, there's laws, right? There's natural laws, right? All universe, the angles of planets, the stars, the sun, the moon, right? All this extended motion of our time for us, and the glorifying God, right? And we live in it. So gravity is keeping us down, the density of our bones keeps us anchored to the earth, right? Then there's laws that we make, right? Don't drive too fast because you might hurt somebody, right? Don't drink and drive, right? Don't use your cell phone. So there's those laws that limit us. And then there's the events in our lives that limit us, right? And so here we are. So we have to do our best with what we have. Think about St. Paul's life. We just heard it yesterday. I know the little guys know the story inside and out because they knew everything about Saul, right? How many children did he have?
One.
And what happened to the child?
He
died. Right? And did Saul go to school? In what city?
Jerusalem.
Jerusalem. Okay? So what does Pittsburgh and his journey to Damascus and his healing. There's something that happens to him that limits him. You know what it is. Thank you.
He saw Stephen get burned.
He saw Stephen, right? He held the garment. Now think about this. He's watching this. This is going to fuel him one of two ways, right? He's either going to feel very merciful to
and involves what our potential is and how it comes about.
We're going to achieve it. Because I want you to think about this when you listen to the next talk. You know, we reveal ourselves in the way we talk and what we say. Right? So St. Paul writes to the Philippians. He's starting to close his letter to the church. The church is having a hard time. He starts to close the letter. And he says something. When somebody preaches sometimes, oftentimes they're talking about themselves, or they're reflecting about themselves, something in their life, right? And they want to give that part of their life to somebody else because they found it of great value. Everybody understand that? The things that I will speak to you about are maybe some of the things that I experienced that I find of great value that I want to share with you so that you can have it, right? It's like giving you money, a better spiritual. Listen. What St. Paul says, and think about his life as Saul, and you'll understand why he wanted the people to hear this. He says to them, be anxious for nothing. Desire nothing. Be anxious for nothing. But in everything, by prayer and by supplication, with thanksgiving. With thanksgiving. Let your requests be made known to God. And if you can do this, man, if you can do this, and the peace of God, which surpasses all understanding, will guard your hearts and minds and through Jesus Christ. Now, you remember when Saul is lying in the house. The scales are on his eyes. Who remembers what he spent those days doing? He wasn't complaining. He wasn't worrying. He wasn't yelling at God. What was he doing?
He was praying.
He was praying. And did God answer his prayers? Yes. That was all preparation for what was to come. Do you see how the man who was once blind and got to know God and was healed by a prayer could tell us that in all of our limitations, whatever they be, whether it's personal limitations, whether it's limitations put on us by God, whether it's limitations put on us by government or family or friends or your school, that if you pray, that if you make supplication, and you do it with thanksgiving, not mad at the other person, but out of love for what's going on. Lord, thank you for taking my eyesight away. Gave me time to pray. And he begins praying. Do all these things with thanksgiving. And God will give you peace that is beyond all understanding. And once that happens, you're no longer proud, but you become one. Such an age.
Humble.
Oh, and then the holy comes in and humble, doesn't it? Because if we're humble, we'll gladly receive the tradition of the church, we'll gladly receive all the laws of God, and we'll be a humble and a holy person. So that's the topic for today. The next topic will be on potential. So listen, remember what you heard? Remember Saul's story about Saul. Begin to think all these things. Very humble and holy people. Very. It's the name of the Father.